Thank you so much, Emma. Thank you, Mr. Lee, Mr. Koo, all the team of Ray for having all of us here. I am very honored and pleased to go with one of the most visionary technologies together with very, very visionary colleagues around, right? Thank you so much. I was asked to talk about face-driven accuracy and aesthetics, so let's go. Awake. I am here with two hats. One in the behalf of International Society, a Digital International Society, which has Ray as a partner. And on the other hand, and the main thing now is me as a clinician. So I started 33 years ago, and I go with you through a little bit of, also a little bit of history and a little bit of the way of treating the full arch rehabilitations, also with importance of the face. So 33 years ago, I had through my mentors at that time the privilege to start with immediate placement, immediate loading with a high success in full arch rehabilitation, but in a free hand surgery until 8 years ago. And we tried to do from all this catastrophic 3D bony situation which was pleasing optically, aesthetically, but without, regardless of the face, right? Now, what we encounter today is that the digital technologies are changing the world, making it a new place, and dentistry becomes a new profession. And that is why I'm so thankful personally also to this digital society, which is creating actually the parameters for this new dentistry. And that is why I'm very glad to be here.
How would you account for this discrepancy between you and the Twin 9000?
Well, I don't think there is any question about it. It can only be attributable to human error. This sort of thing has cropped up before, and it has always been due to human error.
That is why we are thankful that AI-based digital technologies are there, because it's never about an implant, it's never about a graft material, it's never about the, you know, it's always about a human error. And I believe that the human intelligence is creative and social and so on, but the machine, it's sometimes better than us. That is why we have this promise from digital dentistry to give us all these advantages, higher accuracy, and you heard so many nice lectures before, I think it's less to say, but my perspective is a little bit different. I am GP, but I have a training in oral surgery and implantology. I'm doing both, and I would like to share with you a little bit about how we do the education and what is important in the new parameters of digital dentistry as a whole, as a total, not only a couple of aspects. So I will focus, based on science and clinics, on accuracy and aesthetical parameters, where AI and AR, as you will see, plays a role. And you know that the definition of artificial intelligence is actually not right anymore, because AI is not it's not performed like a human mind. Already in 97, Kasparov was beaten by Deep Blue, and 10 years later, it was Stockfish, which was a 16 years playing chess and champion in chess, was beaten in 2017 by Google Alpha, whereas Google Alpha learned from himself and offering much more creative solutions as the human brain. That is why AI is a technology which is not really defined, but we take really big advantage of this, as you could see today too, and have different branches. So whereas human intelligence is more emotional and creative, now the AI is present in so many fields, which are mentioned there, but not only. It are mentioned, are present also in aspects which we don't even know really.